Symbol of the Greek conjunction. It's very similar to some of the symbols for Coeding Cambria and Led Zeppelin. Planets and suns coming into alignment. So this is volume one. I'm not sure how many. Hands. I think that's when they first, what they called it, dream fasting, where they got to see into each other's history by holding hands. They learned about each other. Dream fasting, or, I can't remember. So, time has gone on. This looks like this machine they have in the movie. That is this big, kind of like constellation machine that keeps track of all the planets and the way that they're moving, the stars. Just these symbols here. Cartoon. Went into cartooning and illustration and This is Ogra. Ogra. My bad. A-U-G-H-R-A. Ogra. This is the machine I was telling you about that tracks the planets. She has it in her, I guess, planetarium. She has cool glowing crystals. Telescope. And, she's really, really missing one of her eyes, but then this eye, she kind of like takes it out every now and then and holds it in her hand to like peek around the corner. And that's the freakiest part of the movie. I saw it for the first time when I was like 4 years old and it really scared me. But she seems like a villain at first, but she's really nice. And Frank Oz does the voice for her, so she kind of sounds like Miss Piggy or Yoda or Grover. This is the Gelfling that's in charge while Jen and Kira are sleeping. He's not really a cool guy. From the ceiling of the cave, they're like stalactites, but they look just like gooey hands that grab things. Someone's grabbing a rock, they're grabbing a little critter. You know what they're like is those things you get from a vending machine. It's like gooey hands that you slap against the wall. I love those. Some glowing mushrooms. I think that on Earth, right? Glowing toad schools. Glowing toad stools. I must say toad school. Toad stools. I think so. Maybe I'm just getting confused with Ferd Gully or Avatar. Let me know if in the comments if there's glowing mushrooms in the world. Mushrooms right on his back, right? I think so. Some kind of little land crab. A cute little turtle. Some beautiful stone shell on his back. Glassy little house turtle. So this is and over here, but here she's just completely out of context, surrounded by all cool colors. She sticks out like a sore thumb, like a little sore flaming thumb. My little turtle guys, some little pterodactyl. She's looking for help. And this looks like his eyeball is from Ogra. Ogra. Why do I say Ogra? I think I know Ogra for a whole life. Yeah. she tries to ask the guards for help, but they're not being very hospitable to the extraterrestrial guest. I have Agris Ibox. She's using her third eye now. She must have sent her. In the story of the movie, like a flashback. These are the podlings. These are they're kind of like little dwarves in a way. Cute little babies. They make really amazing music in the movie. Bad decisions. The guy that's been in charge while Kieran and Jen are sleeping. But, Kieran and Jen wake up. I love how they're holding hands. I'm not sure if they've been sleeping for, like, all of the 100 years or just most of it. But, yeah, they shouldn't. Need a villain in order to have a story. She's so cute. All fireling. Oh, there's Kira. She's so amazing. She speaks to animals. She knows all different languages. She's just like totally an alien color. She's totally an alien color amongst all this muted, cool coloring. This is their beautiful planet. I think these are called Landstriders. Trees, gathering nuts, carrying things in baskets. Yeah, know what's going on with these gigantic melting mushrooms. Oh, this, the forest clan is busy with the fire nut harvest. Some big cool beetles. The movie, if that's what they are for the Landstriders, I love them so much. They're similar to oh, my puppy's snoring. They're similar to Salvador Dali's elephants with the long legs, just very exaggerated. Like, actually been listening to her or taking her seriously. Person wearing the suit with an animatronic mask. It looks like her necklace is of the Great Conjunction. My bookmark. So it was made, for Skeksis, actually, I think. This drawing of Skek-Zok, the ritual master, hints at the ornateness of the robes favored most purely sadistic of the Skeksis. Yeah, he is horrible. He's terrible, terrible guy. Kira and Jen are the gelfling roles of the movie. Kira looks very similar. Sticks. And they're doing some kind of Zen ritual drawing in the sand. They have four arms, I believe. There's two men in there. That is Frank. Rewatch this movie and just pay attention and try to look for all different little creatures in the forest. There's just so many. Hand puppet. Over here for Kira. That's the puppeteer underneath her. Probably looking at a monitor. Doing her mouth, I guess. And her hand. Faces are so interesting. They kind of like fish faces, but with little whiskers. So beautiful. Now that's them constructing the lens rider around a mannequin so that a person would be able to fit inside of it. And here's on the stilts, practicing. This is, yeah, just one of those half plant, half animal type creatures that wiggle around in the forest. And it's just a guy in a big wild suit. They just don't make costumes like that very often in movies. It's just so impressive. Here's Kira. You can see, I was talking about that she had more 60s Zooey Deschanel style bangs. And that's her pet Fizzkick that I named my bunny after. My bunny is brown and puffy too. He's half dwarf and half lion's mane, so he has a little puffy head. You can really see Jen's blue highlights nice in this picture. There he is on top of the dark crystal. Then there's this Gexy, he's being scary. Oh, you can see the behind the scenes, right? Ropes? Oh no, that's just curtains. Yeah. Here's the pod people sharing a simple meal. And the grotesque castle, the Skeksis sit down to a decadent banquet. Yeah, they're so extra. The gentle mystics have raised Jen after the slaughter of the Gelfling race. Yeah, that's what I'm curious to find out. In the Dark Crystal movie, there's only two Gelflings, but then the comic book seems like there's a whole bunch of Gelflings, so I don't know, I'm just curious to see how they explain that, because I thought the Gelflings were extinct, other than Kira and Jen. Here's and the planets. It's so cool. Really, really big planets, too. Like, all the different sizes and scales. I mean, I guess our solar system is like that, too, but really puts it in perspective. It's huge size differences. There's Kira. Holding the staff. I forget. I just say what the staff is called. Oh, the ritual master. Works himself into a self-righteous rage. staff can control these minions of the castle. It's like a mind control to, where are they? Like these big guards that they have. Is that them? Or is that, it's kind of a dark picture. No. There's different creatures that are under a trance. Mind control over them. The mystic understand that the conjunction of the three suns will transform their world. Oh, that's right. So it's not planets that are in conjunction, it's three suns. It's so amazing. I really should read the Dark Crystal book. It forever, but I wonder how much similarities it has to the movie. Some more puppets of Jim Henson. After they filmed the Dark Crystal, they filmed the Labyrinth a couple years later. And David Bowie played the Goblin King. So a lot of people have seen the Labyrinth, but they didn't know that there was Dark Crystal that came out before it. The Dark Crystal is all puppets. Like David Bowie and his amazing mullet and leggings. So amazing. This set is inspired by M.C. Escher. All the stairs that go in all different directions. I'd like to see the M.C. Escher Museum in Holland. This is some of the artwork that inspired some of the beautiful creatures and setting in the labyrinth. It's just a masterpiece. I wouldn't be able to pick which movie I liked better. Like between the Dark Crystal and the Labyrinth, they're just so good. Oh, there's Ludo. Oh my goodness. And Princess Diana. What? And then this is George Lucas. Jim Henson and executive producer George Lucas stare intently at a monitor as one of the labyrinth scenes unfolds. I had no idea that George Lucas was the executive producer in the labyrinth. Is Ludo like walking around? Yeah, there's Jim Henson. Labyrinth was chosen at the occasion for a royal command performance, and before the screening, the Princess of Wales was given the opportunity to meet Ludo, one of the movie's most sympathetic characters. Yeah, he is also one of my favorite fictional characters of all time. He's up there with Kermit. I love Ludo. All these cool little creatures. Puppies making a noise. Studio of them making puppets. Here's David Bowie. Oh yeah. Favorite movie when I was little. I forever love Jennifer Connelly. She was like 15 or something when she made this movie. I love her hair in this scene too. I always thought she looked so beautiful. she's really young. And this is one of the characters, Hoggle, that helps her. Both the Labyrinth and the Dark Crystal are just one of those movies I could watch over and over again. They would definitely be my desert island movies. And David Bowie sings